So, everybody's been asking me how I dye my hair. I happen to have found this filter on the L'Oreal Paris Instagram page. It lets you know how the color looks. I'm using the R57. I mix this with a little bit of the C74, and I just went ahead and applied it all over my hair. It's so fast, so easy. It saves you so much time and money, and here are the final results. My hair always feels so soft with this, and the color comes out so bright and shiny. Let me say, you're the one I like. Come on, put your body on might. Keep it up all night.
I have not done my hair in over 8 weeks, and these roots are looking real gnarly, so we gotta tackle them today. So first things first, I'm gonna go ahead and apply my root formula first, and my formula will be listed in the caption down below. Then I gotta call the big guns, aka my fiance Josh. What can I say? He's the best assistant. He helps me. Now the only thing is, can we get him to quit his full-time job and be my assistant full-time? Now, there is no better feeling than getting someone else to wash your hair. Last step, I am going to apply 4 tape and sandwiches to either side of my hair just for a little bit of thickness, and here's the end result. Oh, I feel so refreshed.
I don't like this color, so let's use a color remover again. And yes, this is a mistake. They almost never worked, so let's see what's gonna happen. Heating it up for better results. Are you kidding me? My hair looks completely blue again. I thought I finally got rid of it completely. What in the I'm blue jobbity is going on? At least my hair didn't get damaged. But I gotta find a new way to get this blue out. What should I do?
I was like, I want a bleach and tone. Like, can you do a bleach and tone for me, please? Like, smiley face emoji. And she was like, tone? Question mark. And I was like, a bleach and tone? Like, a bleach and tone, like, bleach and tone, like, what? And so I gave him 2. He said, well, thank you, baby. I said, you're welcome, boo. Never, ever met a guy so fly. Got me hooked like apple pie. I think I'm falling and I don't know why. But I won't fight these buttons. I'm all about him. And he's all about me. And we don't give a damn. Bang, about nobody. About nobody. Cause I'm all about him. And he's all about me. And we don't give a damn. I don't need no fancy car, and I don't need no diamond rings. My baby's all I
My toxic trait is that I think I can pull off any hair color.
And indeed, I was right.
Or I hope to be when I tried out L'Oreal's Bold Color Filter. Hey, we are doing this. The color is multidimensional and has highs and lows, ones much better than your toxic relationship. And unlike your toxic ex, the instructions are actually easy to read.
Easy.
Super fast and easy to do at home.
Purple conquered.
Watch me revive this wig by dyeing it using the Hummingbird by Daikin. I shook up the developing and colorant, and then I put on the beak when it was ready to be used. Even though I'm not demonstrating it here, I do recommend that you have a shirt on or maybe even a covering just to protect your skin. I do prefer the Hummingbird over a brush just because I always have the dye at hand rather than dipping my hand back and forth into a bowl. It is super easy to use, super convenient. I freaking love it. And the results? Exactly how I wanted it to come out. From this to this, I love it. And if you'd like a Hummingbird of your own, the link is in my bio.
We got a pretty easy day today. My first guest is Melissa. You guys have seen me do her hair so many times. She used to be neon orange with a yellow money piece, remember? But now she's got a new job and we got to keep it tame. Like, breaks my heart. But anyway, we're doing a red color melt. I'm doing a level 5 at the roots, a level 7 in the mid strands, and a level 8-9 on the ends. All shades of copper. And this is us finding out some really bad news from my neighbor. But anyway, on any clients that I use alkaline color on, I love to use a K18 Peptide Prep pH Balancing Shampoo. It works wonders. And of course, a K18 mask afterwards. But I always make sure that if I use permanent or alkaline color on a client, that I use something that's going to bring the pH of their hair back to its natural acidic range. That's going to keep their hair nice and healthy and shiny because it brings the hair back to its acidic pH and closes that cuticle. And my second and last guest of the day is Amy. She had some, I don't know if I would call that blonde or brown, bronze, if you will. And we wanted to do brown on top and some rainbow underneath. And she wanted it to be just kind of like dimensional and like each piece is a different color. So I used Redken Shades EQ 6N and a tiny little splash of 6RB for the top and various formulas of Danger Jones Vivids underneath. And those are her results. This was a really easy Saturday, just 2 clients. That feels really good sometimes.
I was like, I want a bleach and tone. Like, can you do a bleach and tone for me, please? Like, smiley face emoji. And she was like, tone? Question mark. And I was like, a bleach and tone? Like, a bleach and tone? Like, a bleach and tone? Like, what do you mean tone? Like, after you bleach it, can you tone it? Like, make it not brassy? And she was like, oh, I understand. And put, like, the blonde princess emoji. And I was like, okay, like, I'm...